Hey everybody, I hope you're doing well. This is Afefe with Touched by Tarot. I am going to take a look for you guys today on the week ahead. I'm recording this on Sunday, the 25th of September, Libra season. We're dealing with this new moon energy, so a good week to set our intentions, but also going to just take a look at what's coming toward us, what the guides have to say, what you should be on the lookout for. Being prepared always helps, right? So going to go right in, been shuffling the cards. I hope you're doing really well. This is a general reading, so it may resonate with many of you. I'd be interested, because we're looking ahead, so I'd be interested to hear back from you if some of these energies did in fact occur and how they impacted you. If you're new to my channel, I hope you like what you see. If so, hit that like and subscribe button. And if you are, you know, one of my regulars, you know how I feel. Mwah, I appreciate you. All right, so let's not waste any time. Let's see what's happening this week ahead. Okay, and I'm going to do it just straight, nothing complicated. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Ooh, okay. I use the card on the bottom of the deck after I shuffle, sort of as a catalyst. Give me an idea of what kind of energy. Ooh, and I'm going to do two just because I saw them both. And they're both major arcana. I don't ignore major arcana. On the bottom of the deck, you all, we got the Fool and an Awakening. So, right off the bat, even before we go into the days of the week, I think we are looking at a very interesting week and a very powerful week, because we got those two major arcana coming right at the bottom of the deck. Awakening, Judgment. This could be a week where ruled by Pluto. So this could be a week where you really have some aha moments, you know, where something clicks, where you are really made aware of something that has changed or should change, something, some sort of growth that you've undergone. That spirit's going to bring to your attention, and that growth is going to take you in a new direction because of the Fool. Two really powerful cards to come together, because you have to have a certain awareness, and maybe even they sometimes call this the card Judgment, the card of second chances. So it could be that you're being given this week at some point a revelation around a second chance that's going to take you in a brand new direction. Let's see what's up with that. All right, let's go Monday. I'm going to put down all of the cards and then reveal them to you. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I'll get clarifiers if I feel like we need them. All right, you all. And I don't always do reversals, for those of you who know my system, but I am feeling called. I've got a couple here, and I'm feeling called to leave them as is. So that's how we're going to interpret them. For Monday, September 26th, we got the Lovers reversed. It could be that there's a decision that you need to make on Monday that you're maybe a little reluctant to do so. It could be that you just haven't reached a resolution yet. Lovers is about... It can be lovers in a partnership and denoting, you know, a relationship, but it also very often is about the decisions that we have to make, you all. The idea that we're presented with a couple of options, and with the Lovers ruled by, you know, Gemini, ruled by Mercury, we want to be really clear, keeping in mind we are still in a Mercury retrograde until October 2nd. So that could very well be why this came reversed and there's been a little delay in your, you know, in your decision making. Makes perfect sense. So don't stress about that. Just be aware that there is something on the horizon that you're going to have to, you know, find that resolution and make that decision, make that choice, and do it in a way that brings harmony. The Lovers wants to be in harmony with another, whether that is in the context of a relationship or even a job, a business, your clients, etc., the relationship to yourself. You want harmony with the Lovers, but not just yet. You know, it could be just a little bit of a delay, and I would say look toward the end of Mercury retrograde, just because that card is ruled by Mercury. So after, maybe at the end of the week, after October 2nd is when you're going to have the clarity to be able, the clarity, awakening, right? Aha moment, to be able to make that decision. On Tuesday, we have the Ten of Wands, busy day. So, you know, Tuesday could find a lot of us just really pedal to the metal and perhaps even having done as much as you can do in a given situation so that you're ready to turn the page. Because when we get those tens, we know usually it's like the absolute, you know, crest of a situation, zenith, where enough, I've done all that I can do. I've managed all the projects as well as I can. I've taken care of all of my responsibilities to the best of my ability. And there's that sense that, you know, on Tuesday, I do want a clarifier for that. On Tuesday, if you're feeling a little overwhelmed or like you've just done so much, that stands to reason. Spirit is acknowledging that. And we have a seven of pentacles that came to cross it. So this is about what you've done. And it could even be not so much, it could be work that you've done, projects that you've managed, but I'm also feeling a little health stuff going on here, like stuff in the body where you are assessing how much energy you have. You are assessing the toll that something is taking on your body, whether that is stress related, whether that is actual, you know, what you're having to do, your fitness regimen, or if you are not feeling fit, maybe you're a little tired, you know, and feeling a little burned out. This could be that Seven of Pentacles coming to say it's time to take stock around that, figure out what's really got you weighed down so that you can clear that up. So that's what's happening on Tuesday. Wednesday, we have the Five of Cups. You know, this is one of those cards that's the easy go-to is disappointment, maybe some emotional struggle, maybe it's a day where your emotions are kind of zigzagging. But I'm gonna take a little curve on this and suggest that Wednesday, you all, you may be in a position to help someone else who's struggling. That's how this feels. It feels like it's coming from the outside in versus maybe you. So be prepared on Wednesday. If you encounter someone who is struggling, I'm going to clarify that and see if I'm on the right track. Just double check myself. But if you encounter someone on Wednesday with that Five of Cups who may be struggling or, you know, someone who wants to talk to you and maybe, you know, vent a little bit about what's going on with them. Here we go. Ten of air. They call it voices in this deck. But the Ten of Swords. Yes. I think someone is on Wednesday. Be prepared for someone who is stressed out, someone who needs some sort of release, and they may turn to you. On the flip side, if this is you, if you are the one who's really feeling and relating and connecting to this energy on Wednesday, then this is a call for you to reach out. Right? Don't try to internalize all of that. Don't try to figure it all out for yourself, but be prepared to reach out because that's going to be your path to healing and getting some clarity around it on Wednesday. All right. On Thursday, we have the Four of Earth. It came reversed. I'm going to leave it that way. I think on Thursday, to the extent that you may, something may happen around you, or you may be in a frame of mind where you're looking at what you have and you're wondering if you have enough. You're being very aware of your financial situation, of your stability, of your home life, of your job even. This feels like this could tie into the workplace if you are working or if you're in business for yourself. But this is an idea of what you have, examining what you have and looking at it more internally. Looking at it like taking stock of what you have, but releasing any fears or any limiting beliefs about, okay, I've got this much, but what else do I need to come in? I've got this many clients, but I need more business. I'm in search of, you know, doing things, improving my presence, improving my product, my services, my education level. This could very well be about preparing yourself for more. Preparing yourself to have more, preparing yourself for better success. But the idea, especially when this comes upright, is don't hold on so tightly to what you have that you miss opportunities to grow it. You know, this can very much be a card around fear of, you know, of stability, fear of knowing that you can have enough and you will have enough. And the idea that it's come reversed, I see it two ways. One is that you'll catch yourself doing that and reverse that behavior, or two, that it is settling sort of internally with you. And this too is making me think about Mercury retrograde, because it's the idea that perhaps you are slowing down enough to take stock of your beliefs around abundance and around what you're able to do, so that you can be sure and welcome more. Open up so that you can welcome more. So that's what's happening on Thursday. On Friday, we had the Knight of Wands. What a great card for a Friday, you know? There's going to be a sense of freedom. You're going to be ready to move on something, perhaps even having loosened up a little bit from Thursday's energy. You know, you're going to be prepared to head toward the weekend. You're going to be prepared to embrace something. I do want a clarifier on that one. I want to see what it is you're moving toward on Friday. That's a beautiful, I love that depiction using the Muse Tarot. Ah, this is freedom from worry. Okay, got it. On Friday, I got the Nine of Swords. So on Friday, there's going to be a breakthrough of some sort. And perhaps, again, going back to what you have, or if you've been thinking about, you know, what you have, there's a lot of assessment that took place this week. Remember, we had that Seven of Pentacles as well. So there's going to be a breakthrough on Friday around just going, you know what? I'm going to be okay. I'm moving ahead. I'm doing what needs to be done, and giving yourself the credit for that. And if there's been this sort of lingering, because nines don't appear overnight. Nines, you know, you build up to that point. So the idea here is that for whatever it's been on your mind, really predominantly occupying your thoughts, and if it's been stressing you out, something on Friday is going to click and you're going to go, not today. Not doing it today. Today, there is a sense of freedom. Today, I'm going to keep moving on it and move past it and get past it. And then on Saturday, we have the Four of Cups. I definitely want to cross that, because that's interesting for me that after having gone through a sense of freedom from worry or doubt on Friday, then on Saturday, Four of Cups is sort of, ho-hum, I'm okay, but I could be better. It's a card very often where you can feel kind of overwhelmed by what's going on around you, but instead of being solutions oriented, you kind of just sit in that energy, right? Just like, I'm in a funk. It is what it is. So let's see how to deal with that and make sure that doesn't take hold. Remembering too, I look down and I'm being called to bring this back to your attention. Remembering that the overarching energy of this week is very powerful. It's not meant to have you sit and feel dissatisfied in any way. It's not meant to have you, you know, in a state of less than what you deserve or less than what you want or settling. You know, it's not meant to have you sit in victim mode. It's meant for power and preparing you to get on to the next thing, taking the awareness that you need to tackle the next thing. And I think the next thing, again, overall, this reading, Knight of, I just went to look at the, because of the way that fell out. That's the Knight of Pentacles. So the dissatisfaction could be that things are moving slower than you'd like, you know, that things are not moving as quickly as you'd like. But that could also be because, remember, this whole week we're at the tail end now of Mercury retrograde. So what was slowed down, there we go. Our final card, the Ten of Pentacles. That's what it is. You want results for all that hard work that you've done. Remember, we had that Ten of Wands. This whole week, there's a lot of work that you realize you have done. Not just what you have to do this week, but it's all this, what's been done up till now, that's building to your financial success, the recovery of your health. For those of you who may be going through some sort of health issue, there is recovery that is being promised here, but it is moving slower than you'd like. And I think that's what may, you know, have you end up the week towards Saturday of feeling like, hello, I'm doing all that I know how to do. So before we close out, here's what I want to leave you with. Remember that. there is an awareness, an awakening. There is definitely spiritual involvement here. Your guides are all the way alive with you, you know, right next to you. And they're saying you're headed in a new direction. There's new that is coming. So don't give up. Hold on to that. Take the steps that you need to take. Do not make the mistake of falling into victimhood. And also, don't take on more. Don't take on people's stuff. I saw people coming towards you this week, you know, perhaps wanting advice, wanting a shoulder to lean on. That's fine, but it doesn't belong to you. You can be supportive without taking it on, all right? That's what I got, you all. Have a fantastic week. Let me know your thoughts, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.